Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. This video builds on concepts introduced in other videos. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the video's overview of 5 wave types in science, an introduction to electromagnetic and mechanical waves, before watching this video.
Hello!
There's nobody else who is speaking in this cave, but this man's echo makes it sound like there's someone else who said the word hello. Sound waves are bouncing off the inside walls and coming right back to him. When we look in a mirror, we're seeing our own image. It happens because light waves are bouncing off the mirror and coming right back to our eyes. Instead of using the word bounce, in physics, we use the word reflection to describe how sound waves make echoes and how visible light waves make images. Wave reflections are just one of many behaviors that all waves can have. In this video, we'll give an overview of common wave behaviors including reflection, absorption, transmission, refraction, diffraction, superposition, and standing waves. We'll start by studying reflection in greater detail. When this water wave hits a seawall, it reflects off the wall with almost the same size and wavelength. The only difference is that its direction is now different than before it hit the wall. This satellite dish has a concave shape. It's designed to reflect radio waves from satellites towards the sensor. These suits reflect infrared waves away from the firefighters. Since infrared waves carry heat, these suits help prevent the firefighters from getting too hot. Although reflections are common when waves encounter matter in the solid state, like this mirror, reflections also happen when some waves encounter matter in a liquid state, like this water. These are metal springs. What do you think will happen to the wave in each spring when it reaches the pole? When the spring's end is held in place, we say it's fixed. When the wave reflects off the pole, it appears to flip upside down. We say it's been inverted, and it's now out of phase with the incident wave. But if the end is allowed to move, we say it's a free end. In this case, when the wave reflects, then it doesn't invert. We say it's in phase. Here's a variation of the string wave hitting a fixed versus an open end. This part of the string is made of light material. This part is made of heavy material. What do you think will happen when the wave reaches the boundary? Part of the wave's energy is reflected, and part is transmitted. The reflected wave is inverted. The reflected wave behaves as though it has hit a fixed end, because it encounters higher resistance to its oscillation. In contrast, if we had started the wave in the heavy part of the string, then when it hits the boundary, both the reflected and transmitted wave will have positive amplitudes. The reflected wave behaves as though it has hit a free end because it encounters lower resistance to its oscillation. Next, we'll introduce absorption. If you've ever been in a recording studio, you may have noticed acoustic foam panels on the walls. These panels absorb sound waves, so prevent echoes. Light waves can also be absorbed. Black dye or paint absorbs more light waves than white paper. When the energy in that light wave is absorbed by a dye or paint, the light wave stops existing, but its energy is instead converted into another form, which is usually heat. Matter in a liquid state can also absorb waves. When we shine lasers through this green dish soap, we find that green light passes through very well, but the red and violet light are absorbed after only a few centimeters. Once absorbed, those waves no longer exist, but the energy they had has been transferred to the soap. Next, we'll discuss transmission. The word transmission is used in many areas of science and engineering. For example, these transmission lines carry electricity. This car's transmission transfers power from the engine to its wheels. But in the context of waves, the word transmission means a wave is traveling through something. All authors use the word transmission to refer to waves traveling through a physical medium, such as visible light waves traveling through this water. Some authors use the word transmission to refer to waves propagating through any space, including a vacuum like outer space. Usually the words transmission or transmit are presented in the context of the words reflection or absorption. For example, green and violet light transmit through this liquid well, but red light has almost no transmission because it's being absorbed by the liquid. We could say the reflections on the outside of these containers prevent some of the laser's light from transmitting through these liquids. Next, we'll introduce refraction. This laser's light beam is bending as it travels from air to water. This is an example of refraction. This happens because the wave's speed is different as it travels through each medium. Refraction is the basis for how we can bend light using magnifying glasses, so that things appear larger. It's also the basis for why glasses work, so that we can see things in focus. Next, we'll introduce diffraction. This is a piece of sheet metal. When we hold the metal close to the paper, the shadow has a sharp line. But when we move the sheet metal farther from the paper, the line starts to become fuzzy. That's because light waves bend at a slight angle as they go past an object in a process called diffraction. Here's an animation of this diffraction. As the distance between the sheet metal and the paper is increased, the light waves can spread out more. As the light waves spread out, they make the shadow's margin fuzzy and lighten up the shadow. We can also see diffraction with water waves. Instead of these water waves going in straight lines after they pass through this opening, they spread out to form a semicircular shape. Diffraction was key to Thomas Young's 1801 experiment, in which he discovered that visible light behaves like a wave. Next, we'll discuss superposition. What do you think will happen when these two string waves meet? The waves go through each other. This is very different than when two objects meet. When two objects meet, they collide. That's because only one object may be in a given place at a time. The key difference between waves and objects is that waves are energy. But the places that they meet will get bigger or smaller waves, depending on how their crests and troughs overlap. We call the overlap of two waves a superposition. There are two major types of superposition that we'll introduce. The first type of superposition is called constructive interference. To study it, we'll sketch sound waves from two clarinets, as heard by the spectators. Wave A comes from clarinet A, and wave B comes from clarinet B. Since they're playing the same note, their wavelengths are the same, and because they're keeping in rhythm, both sound waves are in phase with each other. That means the crest and the trough of each sound wave happens at exactly the same time. We combine these two sound waves by drawing them in the same place. Then we draw the resultant wave by adding up the value of each wave. In this case, the value of the resultant wave's crest and trough waves gets bigger than either of the single waves alone. This is constructive interference. This is why two clarinets played together sound louder than either one played alone. The second type of superposition we'll introduce is called destructive interference. To study it, we'll graph sound waves made by this saw and this person's noise-canceling headphones. These headphones work by having a small microphone on the outside of the ear covering and a speaker inside. The speaker makes a sound wave that has the same wavelength as the saw's noise, but yet the person hears nothing. Wave A is the saw's sound. Wave B represents the speaker's sound. They are on the same wavelengths, but they're out of phase with each other. When these waves are in the same place at the same time, their crests and troughs cancel each other out. The resultant wave is a flat line, meaning there are no sound waves. This is destructive interference. In an ideal situation, the person wearing the headphones will not hear the saw. Our last topic is standing waves. When we propagate this wave down a string, we can see it travels towards the pole, then reflects and travels back. But if we make multiple waves and time them just right, then we get something like this. Now, it's no longer possible to see the wave traveling in a given direction. We call this a standing wave. The places that are still are called nodes. The places that are alternating between crests and troughs are called antinodes. If we change the wave frequency such that there's only one antinode, then the wave may look familiar. This is the same standing wave we get when we pluck a stringed instrument. Other musical instruments also use standing waves, such as wind instruments like flutes and organs. Normally, we see waves traveling away from one place. These water waves are propagating away from this person. In contrast, when we put this container of liquid on top of the fan vibrates the container to make waves. These are standing waves. Here's a summary of this topic, plus some extra information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.